A warm welcome to our series of online support presentations from the Suffolk Psychology and Therapeutic Services. The presenters you'll hear are all members of our inclusion facilitation team. They are experts in working therapeutically with children and young people of all ages who find the social and emotional demands of education hard work. You can find out about the huge scope of the range of support that our inclusion facilitators offer by clicking on the web link below. Each of our series follows the same simple premise: to watch at your own speed and learn at your own pace.
Before we start, please take a moment to reflect on your present level of knowledge about one-page profiles and where you might place yourself along this scale.
What is a one-page profile? A one-page profile captures all of the important information about a person on one page so that it can be shared with those that are working with and important to that individual. At a glance, we are able to get to know what is central and essential to someone, so that we build stronger relationships, and it leads us to being more person-centred. One-page profiles originated in the care sector and are now widely used across education. The simple tool is extremely effective in helping teachers and educational staff get to know their students. Often, one-page profiles are used with children and young people that have additional needs. However, we think that everyone can benefit from having their own one-page profile, and so all our colleagues in the Psychology and Therapeutic Services have developed their own. This video is split into two parts. First, we will explore why it is important for us as professionals to have our own one-page profiles, with a short guide to creating your own. Then, we will share why and how to create a one-page profile with a child or young person.
When we are person-centred, we think very carefully about the importance of welcome. How can we make the young person we are going to work with feel as comfortable as possible? How can we show them that we value and respect them? Before we even meet them, we can use our own one-page profile to introduce ourselves. This can reduce worries about meeting a new person. If they're able to see a picture of us and find out a little bit about us, they'll have a better idea of what to expect when we meet. Including things that are important to us, especially in pictures, can be a helpful way to start conversations and help us find common interests. This can have a really positive impact on building a trusting relationship with the young person very quickly. Giving some details about your role and what you plan to do with the young person can help them to know what to expect and reduce worries.
When thinking about what to include, it's important to consider your audience. If you're writing this to share with a young person, how much do you feel comfortable to share, and how much information can they process at their developmental level? We recommend that you use the following headings when you're thinking about what to share. About me, sharing the things that you are interested in, hobbies you may enjoy, or the pets you have helps create a sense of who you are, which often helps initiate conversation about common interests. What people like and admire about me. This works best if you ask people you know to give you real examples. What is important to me? This could be your core values, what you hope to do in your role, or more personal things that you feel comfortable to share. And lastly, how best to support me? Thinking about what you need from others and sharing this is a good way to model that we all need support in some way. For our children and young people, one-page profiles have many positive benefits. They provide a holistic picture of who this person really is and a safe way to share who they are and what is important to them, balanced with how to keep them emotionally strong and valued for who they are and the contribution they make. The process of creating a one-page profile with a young person provides an opportunity to build relationships, getting to know the young person better, and taking time together to celebrate their gifts. When we take this approach, we can think about what they need to be included, rather than getting stuck with barriers. One-page profiles naturally capture young people's strengths and capacities, focusing on what they can do and helping those working with them to notice all their positive qualities.
A one-page profile must be created with the child or young person. Try sitting alongside them so that you can draw, write, or type together. Make sure they have ownership of their one-page profile and feel that you are there to support them. It is best for someone who spends a lot of time with and is trusted by the child or young person to support them when creating their one-page profile, as it can be difficult to share for the first time. There may be things you already know about them that you can prompt them with. Make sure that you have the time. This can be a great opportunity to build your relationship and to help them to feel heard and appreciated. It can be hard to share, so they need to feel that you have time for them and are keen to take an interest in who they are. It can be tricky for a young person to know what to include in their one-page profile. It is our job to help prompt and guide them. Using these questions as a starting point can help guide the conversation and find things to explore with them. To find out what is important to them, help them to think about their hobbies, interests, the people in their lives. To help them think about how they would like to be supported, consider what their best day would look like, who would be there, what would happen. Use this to agree how they would like to be supported. Often we find it hard to share our positive qualities. Asking them to think about how a friend or family member would describe them can make it easier. If we suggest things that we like or admire about them, it can help them to feel appreciated and valued. Always check that they are happy with what you or anyone else has shared before adding it to their one-page profile. Using templates can be helpful, but make sure there is room for the child or young person to be creative and personalise their page. Once you have included the basic elements, you can be more adventurous and add to the one-page profile. The more information the young person is happy to include, the more of a picture can be communicated. Other titles you may want to add are My Ideal Day, My Worst Day, Things I Don't Like, My Favourites. Allow the young person to have ownership of what they want to include, guided by the template. They may want to create the layout and design themselves. If not, there are lots of templates online that can be easily personalised. A one-page profile should be kept up to date. It can be helpful to review it at least once a year, or if there are upcoming changes. Having a regular time to check in with the young person about their one-page profile can provide an opportunity to find out how they are, any challenges they may be facing, and if you need to adjust your support. If you could now take a moment to remember the number that you chose at the start. Reflecting now on what you have learnt, where do you place yourself along this scale? We hope that this is a slightly higher number and that our introduction to one-page profiles has been both helpful and interesting to you. For further information about one-page profiles and to make inquiries about the support we could offer, please visit our website or contact us via email. Thank you for watching our online support series training. We hope you found it interesting and useful.